Hello everyone, welcome back to Physity class. Hope you all are fine and safe. So just we can memorize what all are the important things which we have discussed in the last class. So here you can see, first we have started the chapter layout of pictures. We started creating the poster, okay, and also we studied what all are the arrangements which we have to create a poster digitally. And also we all will be knowing that for creating the poster we are using a software named GIMP, and we all know how to open also application graphics GIMP. Next we have studied about the four steps that to create a poster digitally. So what are those steps? We have to arrange pictures from different sources. Different sources means either from digital camera or mobile or from internet or from newspapers and all. And the second one is we have to create a canvas. We have to prepare a canvas to arrange these pictures. And the third one is we have to give the background color to canvas. And fourth one, we have to select a message and we have to type that message in the poster. Okay, so these all are the arrangements which we have to do for creating the poster. We all know the different sources also from which we can collect the pictures, that I already told that. And then another one is we have to arrange the canvas. How we can arrange the canvas? In canvas we created a A4 size page. From how we created, from file menu we selected the option create a new page. After that we select A4 size template, then we got an A4 size page. And in A4 size page we gave the background color also. How we gave the background color? We used the blend tool, which is the mix of two colors or dual colors. Like that we select the foreground color and background color. After that we select the blend tool and draw a line on the canvas. So we got the picture. We got the picture in a 3D effect. Okay, so this much we have completed. So in this section we will be discussing more about the canvas and more about to create a poster. So here we will be discussing how to import a logo and how to place a logo in the canvas. Okay, so just have a look. So for that we all know that we have saved the picture. Where we have saved? I will show you. Places, you have to go to home. And in home you can see school folder. I have created a folder named school folder. In school folder, you all will be knowing that I have uploaded the school folder resources in Google Classroom. So those who have computers, you can extract that files and you can create a folder like standard 9. And in standard 9 you can see resources, and in this files I have created one more folder. In this folder, in the school folder, I have created one more folder named student works. Okay, and in student works I have saved our poster. Our poster will be saved in .xcf format. Okay, in GIMP what all pictures we are saving, it will be saved in .xcf format. You all will be knowing that. So I am opening our GIMP, double clicking on the picture, our window will be opening. So we can start the activities. Okay, so we got our window. You can see here the canvas window, our toolbox window and our layers panel window. Here we will be using some specific tools for creating an image, for placing a logo in the canvas. We will be using some specific tools. Okay, So first we have to do is, already our background image is ready. First we have to select a image from outside, from outside folder. We have to select a image. So for that, go to file. In file, you can see open an image file. Go to open. In school resource folder, standard 9, you can see a lot of resources. Here you have to go to the folder images, and in images you can see ILO_logo.png. So this logo you have to select. Okay, those who have computers, at the time you are practicing the activity, at the time of practicing activity, you have to select this image ILO_logo.png and click on open. So what happened here? You can see another window, another GIMP window. This image is opened in another GIMP window. So we have to place this logo on our main canvas, right? So how we can do that? We have to move this logo. So before doing that, we have to memorize a lot of steps. We have to do a lot of steps. So first we have to do is, we have to select this logo only, no need of this background color, only this white color logo is needed for us. So for that, we have to use the tool select by color tool. Okay, you have to note it in your notebook, select by color tool. Either you can click on the tool like this, or shift plus O. You can click shift plus O. So I am selecting here, and slowly I am dragging and I am placing on this, placing on the white color. So what happened? This image, now it is look like a floating image, right? Floating layers are shown on this image. Okay, so after if it is okay, now the floating layer is shown, then we can copy and paste. How we can copy and paste? You can see here edit, menu edit. In edit you can go for copy, and in this window, canvas window, where we have to place the logo, in this canvas window. So here you go for edit menu and select paste. So what happened? This is not visible for us. Okay, we have to enlarge the image. We have to make the image in this format. So what we have to do is, we have to scale the image. So for using that, what we have to do is, we have to select the scale tool. So where is the scale tool? This one. You all will be knowing about the tools and all, which you have, that you have discussed in the last year and all. So click on the scale tool. Click here. So what happened? You can see a window. You can see a box came, a box. It is describing the features of this image. So here either you can change the width and height, or you can scale, or you can drag on the picture. So I am going to drag. Okay. See, I drag this picture. After that, I am clicking on scale. So what happened? This logo came here. This logo becomes, the size is, size also it becomes large. But the floating is not going. Okay, we have to, in a normal way, we have to see this logo in the banner. So the floating is not going. So how we can remove the floating? So for remove the floating, you can see here a window named layers window. Yeah? Okay, so in this layers window, what you can see? You can see a tool named anchor. Okay, so click on that icon. It's not the tool, anchor. Okay, I click on that. What happened? This logo came in a normal format. Now we can see the logo in a normal way, right? So Next, this logo is it is misplaced. I have to place this logo in the correct center portion of this background image. I have to keep this logo in the correct the central portion. I have to keep. So I am using the move tool. Where is this move tool? This one. Move tool, move layers, selection and other objects. So I am clicking on the move tool. I am moving. So what is happening? Along with the logo, our background image is also moving. We don't want our background image to move. We need only the logo. We need only the logo to to place in the central position. We have to place our logo only in the central position. So how we can do that? Again, we have to make our picture in the floating model. Then we can move. Again, we have to play make our normal picture in the floating model. Like this we have to make. So how we can go to that? Here you can see in edit, undo. You can see undo move layer. So I am clicking on undo. It's not undo. No. Again, I am clicking on undo. So what all changes we have, what all changes I have done here, it will take time. Okay. So to get into this previous model, what we have to do? Again, we have to click on the undo. Undo anchor selection model. Okay. After clicking on the anchor, our picture remains in a normal way, but for moving the picture we have to make our normal picture again to the in the floating model. So for that I click on the undo. Okay, so this becomes a floating picture. Next we have to concentrate on layers. So what is this layer? This background image, it is a layer. This we have set a background image in one layer. Okay, we have to place this logo in another layer. This layer means layer editing is an inevitable part of any image editing software. We will be creating a lot of images in GIMP for poster itself. If we want a lot of logo is placed, if we want another image also for editing that image, we need different layers. Each layer exists independently. Usually in image editing, we have to process several images at same time, right? We have to process several images. Here, one image is our background, another image is logo. So in such circumstances, if each image is arranged in a separate layer, they can be edited independently. So we have to keep this each image in separate layer. So our background image is in one layer, so it is showing here only this one. Another one is we have to keep this logo also in next layer. Okay, then only we can edit the image independently. So this now it came to the floating level. Next I am going to click on the menu layer and I'm placing the logo to the new layer. So here you can see another layer forms and it is named as the pasted layer. So what happened? Our picture comes in a normal format, and also I can move. Sorry. While moving, you have to click on this white color logo. Okay. When we click on here and there, our background image also will be moving. So what is the color of the logo? On that color itself you have to click. Okay, so I am clicking on the white color logo and I am moving. So what happened? I can move the logo. I can place the logo anywhere. So I am placing it in the central position. Here also some mismatch happened. So what I am doing is I'm placing my background image also in the correct format. Okay, So this much we will be discussing here. So I place the logo. Okay, so just I will summarize what all things we have done. So for that, see, we have saved the file in .xcf format, that is poster.xcf. Another step what we have done is we have to bring our picture to Canvas. So how we can bring the picture to Canvas? In Canvas page, you can see an menu, file menu. In file menu, select the option. Select open. Open option you have to select. After that, you can select the image where we have saved from that folder. We can select the image. Okay, so next what we have to do, the image opens in a new GIMP window. It opens in a new GIMP window. You can see here, it opens in a new GIMP window like this. Okay, so next what we have to do, next select the white color logo only. Only we need to select, we have to keep this logo here, right? So we have to select the white color logo only, no need of background, only the logo we have to select. So select the white color logo using select by color tool. Which is that tool? Here, select by color tool. Next what we have to do, we have to drag and click on the white color. We have to use the select by color tool and slowly drag and click on the white color. So at that time what happens is white color logo turns to the floating selection. In this format it will turn, right? Like floating selection. This white color turns to the floating selection. So after that what we have done? I go for edit and I click on the copy and I have to paste it in our main window. So there I can see an edit option. In edit I take paste option and I place the window. I placed the logo. So at the time of play, after I placed also, this logo is, the size is very small. I can't see the logo. It is not visible to us properly. So we have to scale the image. We have to scale the logo. So for that, what we have used? We have to scale the logo. So for that, we have to use the click. We have to click on the scale tool. Here you can see the scale tool. Which one is that? This one. Click on the scale tool. So at that time a box will appear regarding the information, giving the information of this logo. Either you can change the height and width from that box, otherwise you can scale, or else you can scale the picture. You can increase, you can drag the picture. So it will be increased, and after you press on the scale button, so we will get the picture in this format, but the floating will not be gone. So we have to remove the floating. So for removing the floating, which option we have to select? To remove the floating selection, you will be we have to select the anchor tool. Anchor tool in the layer window. Which one is that anchor tool? Here, this is the anchor tool. We have to select anchor the floating layer. So this we have to select. When we select this, our logo came to in the normal format, right? So after that what we have to done, we have to place the logo in the central position of the canvas. So for placing that, we have to move. After you all saw that I placed the logo here, and I think here I placed. So I have to bring the logo to the central position. So what I have done, I have to move that picture. So for moving, I have to go for, I have to take the move tool. Move tool. So I took the move tool, but while moving, what happened? Along with the logo, our background image also moving. So it will not be correct. We have to correct the logo in the proper way on the background image. So for doing that, we have to create a new layer for the logo. Okay, we have to create separate layers for background image and the logo. So how we can select that? How we can create that? We have to undo the logo in our floating format. We have to select in edit. We have to click on undo. In undo option, we have to select and we have to make our logo in this floating format. After that, which tool we have to take? We have to go to the layer tool, layer menu, and from that layer menu, there will be an option to the layer. Here already it was done, that is why the options changed. Normally what we have to, the option will be this one. Select layer to the new layer. We have to place our logo to the new layer. Okay. So what will happen? The floating selection will be gone and we can move the picture easily. Like this, click on the white color logo and we can move the picture easily. Okay. So this much we will be discussing in this class. So this much we have created. Next, what we have to do, we have to save our picture. So for saving, where we have to go? File, save. Okay, after practicing the activities, after drawing the pictures, first thing we have to do is we have to save that. Okay, without saving, what will happen? Next time when you open the window, nothing will be showing there. So we have to save after each activities, we have to save. So I save the picture. So now I am closing. Okay. Sometimes you can see, I will, sometimes this toolbox also will not be visible to us. Okay. Sometimes when we open this Jimbo window, only this canvas window will be visible. Or else this canvas and layers window will be visible. This toolbox window, sometimes it will not be visible to us. So for taking the toolbox window also, there is an option. You go for this windows menu. Here you can see the toolbox window. If layers window is not visible, go to Dockable Dialogs and take layers. Okay. This is some. This is to keep in mind. So what I am doing is, I am closing. Okay. So our window closed. This is a separate window. So I am closing this also. Okay. So this much we have studied in this class. So this is some theory part, the steps and all that you can note down in the notebook. I will give the fire notes also. Okay. See this. This is for your to keep in mind about the floating layers. Floating layers are the temporary layers that have the same features of a normal layer. Okay, it will be having the same features of the normal picture. Okay, but the, we are using this floating layers for editing. For editing, we are using the floating layers. The next one is layer editing. Layer editing means it is an inevitable part of image editing. Okay, each layers exist independently. If each we will be using a lot of images for creating poster, so we have to place each image in separate layer, then only we can do editing. Okay, so to add new layers, you can click on the icon. Okay, there will be option here, create a new layer. So for adding to this new layers, we can click on this icon. So we will be getting the new layer added, and we can if you want to give color and all, if you want to create and copy layers, there will be options for doing that. So this is just for your reference and all. So in upcoming activities, we will be discussing it in a detailed way. Okay, so this much we have studied. Just we will summarize what we have discussed how to place the logo in the poster. For that, we use the tools select by color tool, move tool for moving the picture, anchor tool for what purpose? For removing the floating layers. Select by color tool for what purpose we used? for taking our picture and to place it in the canvas window, we use the select by color tool. After using this tool, floating layers comes on that image. After that, from edit we took copy and we paste it in the main window. After that, we have created a new layer. So for creating a new layer, where we have gone in layer, in the layer menu, we took the option to the new layer option. Okay, so this much we have discussed in this section. So before winding up, in the last section I have given some homework, so we will be discussing the homework. This previous homework, it was first question, how to open GIMP application, graphics, GIMP, like that. Second question was 4 steps to create poster. First we have to arrange pictures and save in computer, and second step we have to prepare the canvas, third step we have to add the background color to canvas, and the fourth step we have to show a message in the poster. Third question was the tool used to mix 2 colors in GIMP. Which was that tool? Blend tool. We will be giving foreground color and background color, and we will be using the blend tool. So actually I forgot to discuss about this homework in the last Google Meet. So in upcoming sections we will be discussing about homework in the Google Meet. Okay. So what you have to do is you have to practice activity. You have to practice doing activity. Those who have computers, others you have to note down all the steps. Okay, I will be asking questions in the next class, so you can answer it properly. The homework for the next session is, first question is tool used to move the picture. For moving the images, which tool we have to use? Second question is how to create a new layer. How we can create a new layer? Which option, which menu you have to select for creating the new layer? The third question is what are floating layers? Okay, so you have to write down the answers in your notebook. In the next Google Meet session, we will be discussing the questions. Okay, we will be discussing the answer. I will choose randomly. I will choose the students, and you have to give answer to me. Okay. So hope it is clear to you. Hope you got you got information regarding these topics and all. So next class we will be discussing more about creating poster and all. So see you in the next class. Be safe. Okay, thank you.